out of Kyle May, row 3. The 43 is Tom Maddox. Outside is Bradley Llewellyn, row number 4. The S23 of Justin Owens. Outside of him, it'll be Shane Smith in 4S. And William Overby will tag the tail end. 9 cars getting ready to go 12 laps. This will determine who will start 5th in tonight's 40-lap feature. The winner are going to start, start 9th in tonight's 40-lap feature. 2 proven track champions on the front row. In the 42 of Casey Hall with the 11 of Bobby Ritchie Jr. is going to get the jump. 12 laps up, coming up 4. They'll go to the line. Green is out, run away. Into turn number 1, Richie's going to edge just a little bit on the top side, 3 wide in the back of the pack now, as Bobby Ritchie and the 42, Casey Hall side by side for the lead down the front straightaway, give lap 1 to Ritchie. Hall will lead lap, will be in 2nd now. Kyle May is 3rd, trying to run the top side. 4th is turn, 5th will be the 43 of Tom Maddox as they come through 3 and 4. 2 laps in the books. Bobby Ritchie continues to lead. Now here comes the Iron Man. Matthew Turner looking for 3rd down. Back straight away under Kyle May. Can't get it done. Good battle starting to heat up. Casey Hall, the Hurricane, on the move in 42. The snap-on rocket trying to get things going all over Bobby Ritchie. Great battle for the lead out of turn number 4. Richie's going to hold it. 5 in the book, 7 laps to go. Kyle May holds on to the 3rd position. Now the Iron Man, Matthew Turner, is under attack from the 43 of Tom Maddox as they roll into 3 and 4. Bobby Ritchie continues to lead in 11 as they go back into 1 and 2. Calm down 3rd on back as your leader starting to pull away. Now Bobby Ritchie in 11 leads down the back straightaway. We've hit the halfway point, 6 in the book, 7. 6 laps now to be 5 laps to go at the line. Kyle May continues to run in the 3rd spot. Turner slips off the bottom. That's going to open the door for Tom Maddox to close. Now here comes the Hurricane. Casey Hall putting pressure on Bobby Ritchie for the lead as they go down the back straightaway. Oh, the former Boyd Speedway champion and the former Fort Payne Motor Speedway champion going at it as they come to the line. 3 laps to go in heat race number 1. Now Ritchie gets him good and cleared. About 2 car lengths as they go into turn number 3. Ritchie running through the middle of the Speedway. Casey Hall running the very bottom. Closes back up as they go through 3 and 4. Here comes the Hurricane again. Casey Hall appearing just to be a little bit faster, but can't get it done. He smacks the backstretch wall. Casey Hall in a 42 smacked the backstretch wall. He keeps going right. Flag 1 to go. 1 to go for Bobby Ritchie down the back straightaway, looking to start 9th in tonight's 40-lap feature. They'll come through 3 and 4 for the final time. It's going to be a drag race to the line. It's going to be Bobby Ritchie Jr. 2nd's going to go to Casey Hall. 3rd will be Kyle May. 4th is Matthew Turner. And 5th will be Tom Maddox. So bringing home 3rd will be the 55 of the Pisk, Alabama drivers, Kyle May. 2nd will be the 42, the Hurricane out of Rainesville, Alabama's Casey Hall. And your winner of heat race number 1 will start 9th in tonight's 40-lap feature. The driver, the 2014 Boyd Speedway track champion out of Ooltewah, Tennessee, Bobby Ritchie Jr. Had their times disallowed. They were relegated to the end of this B main. So going to be interesting. That was your 1st and your 5th fastest qualifiers in group number 2. Going to be starting back there on the tail end. Going to be very fun to watch those two try to come to the front. As Matt Henderson and TJ Britton will lead them to the stripe, 1 to go signal. keep your eye on that 117, the points leader, looking for his first win on the year, leading the points. 23 points is the gap. This could be a huge points night for Rusty Ballinger as well. If Jake Teague is not able to get it done here tonight, as they come to the strike, green is out, we're underway. It honors contact in turn number one. Line of contact between Kazar and the 05 of Britton. That opens the door for the team man. Jake Teague's going to go to second. Britton's going to slip back to third. Your leader is Matt Henderson. Now side-by-side battle for the fourth spot between Todd Morrow and the 157 of Kenny Kazar down the back straightaway. See Ryan King and Jason Wilson trying to work on coming to the front. They're three wide for the fifth spot as they come off turn number four. Henderson continues to lead. J.T. running in second as they go down the back straightaway. Britton running in third. Here comes the Sail Creek Assassin. In fourth, Kenny Kazar with a big runoff turn number two, trying to run down Britton for the third spot. So we're single file for the meantime. Morrow lurking back in fifth. There you see the 30 of Ryan King, the 29 of Jason Wilson, fifth, sixth, and seventh. All cars going to transfer. Now Wilson starting to put some pressure on Ryan King as they come down the back straightaway. Matt Henderson, that Bruce built rocket, the Dwayne Hallmanoil car, out front, leading here in heat race number two. Now good battle for fifth as they'll roll out of turn number four. Morrow really getting heavy pressure from Ryan King's 30, and Britton's going for a third. And one and two. So that'll... Riley, of course, not in action here tonight. The only repeat winner on the 2015 season, Anthony White, got a points win down at Duck. Actually, that was the non-points event that he won down at Duck River. 5,000 went home in Clinton, Tennessee with Anthony White. So we go back to green. Henderson leads him into turn number one. Teague is back in second. Here comes Wilson, shoot out of a cannon. Down the back straightaway. Good run on the top side. Here comes the flying Wilson on top. He's got fifth. He's looking for fourth. Side by side with Todd Mosley going to turn number one. Good bite on the top side. Jason Wilson has found some on the top side of the speedway. Everybody trying to run the bottom. Jason Wilson liking what he sees up top as Todd Morrow slides him. They're side by side at the line for fourth. Good battle for fourth. Now Kenny Kazar trying to hold him off for third. Wilson with another big run down the back straightaway. He's going to close for fourth. Here he comes for third. Looking under the Sail Creek Assassin as they go into turn number one. Kazar will hold the spot. There was a little bit of contact. Looks like Kazar may have a soft left rear tire. Going to have to keep an eye on that now. Battle for the fifth spot's going to be between Morrow and the 30 of Ryan King as they go back into turn number one. Now that three wide coming down out of turn number two. A little contact. Rush and King and the other Todd Morrow went three wide as white flag's going to come out. One to go for Matt Henderson. Jake Teague sitting comfortably in second. Third is the 157 of Kenny Kazar. Wilson has marched up into fourth. Britton's going to pull off in the back straightaway. Your winner of heat race number two will start 10th tonight. It'll be Matt Henderson. Second's going to go to Jake Teague. Third will be the Sail Creek Assassin. Kenny Kazar, fourth, will go to Jason Wilson from the tail. Nice charge in the top side. So Matt Henderson wins heat race number two. He will start 10th in tonight's 40-lap feature. 24 cars sitting six rows deep, getting ready to put on a Southern Tennessee show for you tonight with the United Crate Racing Alliance. Round number five of the points chase. And one lap to go, and we're going racing for 40 laps here tonight. Roll line down the back straightaway, 2 by 2, 12 rows deep. Getting ready to tour this little bull ring for 40 laps. It is full time. We're going green at 411 Motor Speedway. The dirty white boy Anthony White jumps out to the early lead down the front back straightaway. Now here comes Risky Ballinger. What a strong move. 3 wide. He goes to 4th. Lap number 1 goes to the dirty white boy. Here comes the new crew in B00. He's at the 2nd. Jay Brinkley bouncing around on the top side of the speedway. As he went 3 wide down the back straightaway for 3rd, it's going to continue to be the dirty white boy, Anthony White, looking for win number 3 on the season in 2X. Josh Henry, the Jet, having his best run of the season so far. Great battling all the way back through the field, 2 and 3 wide. Henry trying to put some pressure now on the dirty white boy, 3 in the books. 37 laps to go. Here comes little John Olby to the inside of Jay Brinkley. Little John Olby starting to work the bottom side of the speedway. We got cars starting to stack it back towards the middle of the pack. Everybody's going to make it through okay. 3 wide back there for about 8th and 9th. Big crash in turn 1. Cars are everywhere in turn 1. And the caution is out. Well, we'll have 4 scored. 36 to go. Contact between Smokey. Out of 4, they're back underway. Signal this time. Anthony White ready to go back racing, tried to get away from that 44. A little John Olmby, man, he has been on a tear. The Cleveland, Tennessee driver in 44, been really tough. Got that crate late model just a few weeks ago and has finished top 5 every feature. He has pulled onto the racetrack, and it looks like he's going to be in contention for another 2,500 to win again here tonight as Anthony White will come through 3 and 4. We're back underway. Little John, little contact with the double zeros. They go into 1 and 2. And Henry giving him a good run. Here comes Jake Brinkley with a huge run. Down the back straightaway in 10. Runs up onto the back deck lid of the B00, but it's going to be Anthony White leads. Cars down the back straightaway. Good battle for the fifth spot. Now contact between Jake Teague and the 29 of Ballinger. Matt Henderson can't figure out where he wants to go. Good battle for the fifth spot right now. Ballinger will clear off the top side. Here comes Henderson on the top side looking for sixth. Jake Teague trying to make something happen on the bottom. Everybody line back up, one to go signal getting ready to go. Now with one car off the speedway, Jake Teague currently scored in the 21st spot. With second place in points, Rusty Ballinger up to fourth. Here we go. Trying to work over the top side in 2H as they'll come off of turn number four. Good battle with Ballinger for the fifth spot. And now he'll duck under Jay Brinkley. Not going to see anything. Here comes Henderson to the top side. He wants in the top five. Good battling all the way back through the field. Keep your eye on the 117 Jake Teague, and we've got a problem. 07 of Bradley Lewelling is in trouble in turn number four. Yellow's gonna fly. Zero. Seen a lot of drivers getting really good runs off that top side of turn number two, because they're gonna be very interesting to see if he can get a good run down the back straightaway and fall into the runner-up spot and make a challenge for the lead. Here we go. Tries to look to the inside for now. Jay Brinkley slides. All kinds of problems. They're going to go four wide down the back straightaway. Racing for the fourth spot. A lot of contact. Jay Brinkley trying to hold on to fourth. And Rusty Ballinger back to fifth. A big stack of benefits straightaway. Well, let's see if they can all come out of it. Indeed, they will. Dirty White Boy will continue to lead on the Little John. OMB a second. Third is the B00. Now, Jay Brinkley settles down back into the fourth spot with Rusty Ballinger fifth. Good battle for seventh, eighth, and ninth right there. Todd Kaufman getting a little loose. Coming through one and two. He's going to lose a few spots. Trying to run the top side of the racetrack. Now, get a good run back on Wish in the 29. Starting to try to come from the tail end of the field. Now, good battle for fifth between Ballinger and the H2 of Matt Henderson. And Henderson going to try a slider, not going to do it. Out of turn number four. 20 in the books, 20 laps to go here at 411 Motor Speedway. The Dirty White Boy continues to lead. Yeah, Justin Owens with a problem down in turn number one and two. He will keep going. And it's 23 as the battle for the lead heats up. Down the front straightaway, here comes Little John on the coming into one and two. Good battle for the lead. Little John on the bottom. Anthony White on top gets that top side advantage. Now dives back to the bottom in three and four as they try to work. And down the front straightaway, 23 in the boat, 17 laps to go. And looking right in front of them, got two lap cars side by side. Now a problem in turn number four is Matthew Turner. And a big crash in turn number one. So the caution came out for the 10 of Matthew Turner when contact ensued in turn one, collecting Todd Morrow and Kenny Kazar, 23 in the books. So we'll get everything sorted out. They're back on the gas. We're back underway. Anthony White leads them down the front straightaway into turn number one. OMB looks to the bottom now. The boot crew still trying to get a good run. Here comes Casey Hall at 42. The Hurricane is on the move. Out of Rainsville, Alabama, Casey Hall to the bottom. He wants the podium spot. Fourth in the series points in the snap on 42. Looking to try to take over third. Can't quite do it. Now here comes Jason Wilson, shot out of a cannon. Matt Henderson got sidestepped by three cars like he was sitting still. Meanwhile, back up front, Anthony White and Little John Orme battling hard for the lead. The Boo crew trying to hold down third with Josh Henry. Now the 42 of Casey Hall trying to put pressure on for the third spot. And there's problems down the front stretch. Big contact with the H2 and the 56 of Jordan Horton. They'll keep everything clean. We'll stay green. Now three wide. Here comes Ethan Hunter. There's contact again with the 56 of Horton, who's got a lot of cosmetic damage on the 56. Ryan King, now the 56 is off the pace. Caution, caution. And Jordan Horton will fall off the pace with a left rear flat. So the Hancock it man, Jordan Horton, has problems. So we'll get one to go this time by, as the 56 of Horton's going to return to the Speedway. Gets that left rear change, gets that sheet metal tape down. Going back to green, 27 in the books, 13 to go. Anthony White's back on the throttle, we're back underway. Now Casey Hall tries to duck to the low side, tries to get an advantage, can't do it. Josh Henry trying to rock it off the top side. Casey Hall slips up the track and he's going to stack them all up. Down the back straightaway. Now here comes Jake Brinkley in 10. Can't quite get it done. Casey Hall will hold him off. Anthony White continuing to lead with a lot of pressure from the 44. Now Matt Henderson almost slides up and causes a major problem. Trying to run the bottom side of 1 and 2. They'll get it all fixed out. Little John Orme, good battlefield lead down the back straightaway. Can't quite get the bite off the bottom. Anthony White continues to lead. Little John is second. Third is the 00 of Josh Henry. Fourth, the 42 of Casey Hall, and Jay Brinkley holds on to fifth. JT starting to try to work his way back towards the front in 117. Good battle with side-by-side with him and Bobby Ritchie. Now Casey Hall starting to close in on the B00 down the back straightaway. Good battle between him and Josh Henry. The battle for the lead still rages on up for Little John Ormby. Dedicated to the bottom side of the Speedway. Can't quite get it done. Anthony White running good off the top side. Now here comes a flying Wilson. Ducks into the 10 of Jay Brinkley looking for the lead. Can't quite get it done. 33 in the book, 7 laps to go. They're side by side for the lead down a back straightaway. Laps to go. Now this one's going right down to the wire. Could it be another nightmare for Anthony White with 3 to go at Fort Payne Motor Speedway? He lost the lead, and at that time it was to Tom Maddox, who was retired from this event so far. Trying to hold on again here tonight. 5 laps to go around 411 Motor Speedway. They've pulled about a half a track away from Henry and the 42 of Casey Hall, who continue to battle for third.
Yeah, that's fine.
4 laps to go now. Anthony White trying to hold on. Little John Ormby trying to battle in the lap car. May be an issue here. William Overby in 7. Kind of in a way now. Anthony White has to get up the top. Good battle down the back straightaway. They're still right together, right on the rear deck leader.